You're listening to episode number 77, How to Know What's Keeping You Stuck in Manifestation. Welcome, my love, to the Boss Bitch Rising podcast. My name is Coach Kale, and I am your host. I'm a master mindset and alignment coach with over 10 years of experience as an entrepreneur. I got my start as a personal trainer in the health and wellness industry, and in getting to work so closely with the human body, this allowed me to see the powerful connection our subconscious mind has not just over our physical body, but also our physical reality. So I started diving deep into the power of the subconscious mind, and have since become certified in many modalities, including NLP or neuro-linguistic programming, hypnosis, EFT, Reiki and energy healing, among others. I now apply these modalities to elevate the collective consciousness of not just my clients, but also my soul tribe. It is my mission in life to create a profound, positive ripple effect, to get you realigned and reconnected with your true, more authentic self. It's time to be the leader of your life, my love. Now let's rise up. Hello, my love, and welcome back to another episode of Boss Bitch Rising. I'm so grateful that you are here with me in today's episode. And before we hop into all of the goodness packed into this episode today, I do want to share with you that I am hosting an event that is coming up next week called Inner Goddess Awakening. In this event, it is a 3-day free live event where we are really going to go deep into what is keeping you stuck with manifestation and in pursuit of all that you desire to attract in your life. So in day one, we are going to connect inward, and here we're going to take a deeper look at who you are at your core. This includes your past experiences, your upbringing, possible traumas and triggers that you have, fears, challenges, limiting beliefs, all of the ways that you think and are showing up in your current reality. And I will guide you in understanding yourself on a deeper level than ever before. Then day two, we are going to go into letting go and healing of those things that are keeping you stuck. Once I show you what really is beneath the surface of who you are and really help to strip away some of those superficial things so that we can go really deep, this will make it more apparent what is holding you back in life. And I will address or touch on some of that in today's episode. I also will guide you in releasing the past, detaching from those things that are holding you back and continue to hurt you even on a subconscious level. Sometimes we don't consciously know, or we're not consciously aware of what's holding us back or of what is continuing to hurt us, but I want to guide you in understanding this so that we can remove, heal, reprogram all of these things, and then guide you towards your truest, most aligned self. And then day number three is awakening your inner goddess. I will guide you in awakening to your truth and aligning with your highest self. This will make manifesting easier, establishing quality relationships more fulfilling, and truly awaken this new love and passion that you have for not only yourself, but also your life. Therefore, allowing you to become a magnet of attraction for all of your dreams, desires, and really just everything that you want out of life. So Inner Goddess Awakening does start next week. It's Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, February 15, 17, and 19, 2021. If you want to register for this free event, all you got to do is go to my website, kaleroberts.com, click on the Start Here tab, and it's right there at the top of the page. Of course, if you have any questions, if you're wondering if this is the right event for you to attend, do not hesitate to reach out to me. I would love to open the conversation and really help guide you in the right direction for you. If you're having any hesitancies, questions, concerns, whatever it might be, know that I am always here to help. So again, go to kaleroberts.com, click on the Start Here tab, and you'll see the Inner Goddess Awakening free 3-day training registration right there. I cannot wait to see you there. And let's hop into today's episode, because we've got some juice for you today. How to know what is keeping you stuck in manifestation. So if you are feeling stuck with your manifestations, this is a clear sign that something is not in alignment. Something's not quite clicking, or you're keeping yourself stuck or blocked in some way. So based off of the knowledge that I've shared Through NLP, our subconscious mind is actually the one that's in control. When we're speaking, like even right now, me sharing this knowledge with you, this is knowledge that's already in my brain. This is stuff that I've said so many times that it's there. I don't necessarily have to consciously think about every single word that's leaving my mouth in order for me to deliver this content and information to you. Our subconscious mind is actually in control of more than 90% of our functions from day to day. So with that being said, we have habits and patterns, thought patterns, speech patterns, and behavioral patterns that have been there for a long time, probably longer than they should be. These patterns, no matter when they were instilled in order to protect us. And at one point, they probably served us really well in protecting us and guiding us in the best way. But as we naturally evolve as human beings, we're going to evolve past certain patterns. But if we're not consciously aware of these patterns and working to remove or rewire some of the patterns that are not serving our highest and best good, then this is what's going to keep us stuck. Most of the time, when we need to rewire certain things, this means that healing needs to take place. When we heal, this allows us the opportunity to reconnect with our truth. When we reconnect with our truth, this allows us to step more powerfully into alignment, into confidence, into passion, into love, into joy, into all of the high vibrating frequencies that allow us to become an energetic match for all that we are in the process of attracting. If we're operating from a place of lower vibrating frequencies like fear, guilt, shame, anger, lack mindset, then we are also going to be a match for those things and attract those into our life. So if you're not clicking with your manifestations, if something feels stuck in your life, if you feel like you're trying and trying and trying, but it's just not happening for you, this is a clear indicator that there is something in your pattern that needs to be healed, and therefore you can get reconnected with your truth and authenticity, and then step into deeper, more powerful alignment with your higher self, therefore becoming a magnet of attraction. Typically, when it comes to healing, though, there is some underlying event. We as adults have all endured some type of traumatic event within our life. I would say that most people, when they think of trauma, though, they think of these like big events, something like going to war or a natural disaster or enduring abuse or neglect or experiencing an accident or some type of addiction or something like that. Like, we think of the worst things, these big things. But traumas can also be small things. I mean, I would say for what it's worth, last year was pretty traumatic for a lot of people on a financial level, on an uncertainty level, on a level of like maybe you weren't able to see your family and you had withdrawals from actually having physical touch, like human touch from people and socialization. So trauma can be a wide range here. There can be lots of different things that are traumatic, and each individual is going to store these traumatic events differently. If you grew up in a household where, you know, alcoholism, or maybe you had a narcissistic parent or a verbally abusive, physically abusive, emotionally abusive parent, typically if you've endured traumas over a long period of time, especially from when you were a kid, traumatic events when you're an adult are not that big of a deal because you're essentially desensitized to trauma. But if you haven't endured trauma as a child or over longer periods of time, therefore you're not desensitized to it, then other forms of trauma that other people might see as nothing are actually big deals. So trauma definitely depends on the individual. It also depends on when the trauma took place, the period of time over which the trauma has taken place, and then also how you're storing it mentally, physically, and emotionally. When we store trauma and we don't address it, we just kind of like push it to the back of our mind. Over time, we feel like, you know, you've heard the saying, time heals all wounds, and that's not the case. We want to trick ourselves into thinking that time heals all wounds, But in reality, this trauma is getting stored on a subconscious level and continuing to play out in your reality. You're continuing to manifest certain patterns in your life, certain scenarios, certain relationships based off of this unresolved trauma. And trauma can cause a wide range of physical and emotional symptoms, but the longer that you are exposed to traumatic events or environments, the more desensitized that we become to the feelings associated with trauma. And actually, we can actually seek out, whether consciously or subconsciously, scenarios that mirror the trauma and feed the triggers. That's essentially perpetuating the cycle. That's essentially what's keeping you stuck. So on a conscious level, you don't want these things. You're like, why does this keep happening? Why do I keep attracting these kind of men? Why do I blah, blah, blah? On a subconscious level, you're subconsciously doing this for yourself to protect you, or because it's familiar to you, because you've had this pattern for such a long time, this way of living for such a long time. And so it is so important for us, if we are feeling stuck, to really identify the pattern first. And then what behavioral patterns or experiences or relationships or what have you taught us to continue to perpetuate these cycles. Every single adult has endured multiple traumatic events within their lifetime, whether they know it consciously and are aware of it or not. And the thing about this is, if you have endured a traumatic event and haven't fully processed it or healed from it, then you're most certainly storing it on a subconscious level and acting in accordance with this trauma and how you show up in your day-to-day life. Again, like I mentioned, certain big events like returning from war, sexual assault, a car accident, witnessing some type of crime take place, a natural disaster. I mean, there's so many big events that we think of, but there's other forms of trauma like financial struggles, losing a friend or a parent, especially at a young age, and especially if it was unexpected. An emotionally absent parent or narcissistic parent, or growing up in a single parent household where your primary caregiver is always working or away from the family so that they can provide. This can actually cause a lot of subconscious programming and trauma that we might not realize was traumatic to us. This can start to manifest in how we're showing up in relationships, in our life, in our career, what types of people we are attracting into our life. If you had a narcissistic parent growing up, then you are typically going to attract narcissists into your life. If you are constantly feeling like within your relationships, you're attracting people that are very self-serving, that expect of you more than they are willing to give back to you in the relationship, that are demanding of your time, your energy, your affection, your attention, whatever else, but they won't give you the same back, then it's quite possibly you grew up in an environment where you had someone that acted just the same way, and you're manifesting that back into your life because on a subconscious level, this is what's familiar and this is what feels right to you. But it's time to start recognizing these patterns of our life. Whatever that pattern might be for you, it's time to start recognizing it so that we can create deeper, more profound healing. Something as small and simple as limiting beliefs around money, or a poor self-image, or an emotionally absent but physically present parent can have a huge role in how we are showing up in our life. From how we spend or receive money, maybe you overspend and you cannot seem to reach your financial goals, and it seems like, why can't I just control myself? Or maybe you are presenting yourself in certain social situations. Maybe you feel like you need to hide who you really are, or maybe you feel like you need to overcompensate by having to look perfect or act perfect or be the caregiver or always providing more value than the value your relationships provide back to you. Maybe the relationships that you get into, maybe they have some form of like anxious attachment style, and you find yourself constantly getting into relationships that are toxic or abusive or neglecting you, people who just don't really seem to care about you. What are the patterns for your life, though? It's time to really take a hard look. Sometimes they're subtle. Sometimes it's just these little things that we're like, It kind of bothers me, but that's just how they are. Or, oh, it's just been like that forever. Or, oh, it's just not that big of a deal. I'll be okay. This is you silencing yourself, your wants, your needs, and desires to people please others, or continue to perpetuate a cycle that you know feels uncomfortable, yet you continue to choose to be there. In order to move out of this stuck feeling, we have to be self-aware. And in this self-awareness, we have to be nurturing to ourselves, our wants, needs, and desires. And then we have to take intentional action and consistent intentional action to heal from wounds that may seem small, but the more that we allow these patterns to play out, not only the harder is it for us to get away from these patterns, but the more that we try to convince ourselves that it's okay. But you're not being serious enough with how you love yourself. And at the end of the day, this is going to have the greatest impact on you, only you in your whole life. I shouldn't say only you, because you have responsibilities in your relationships and in your life that also affect other people around you. Think like the ripple effect. So think of it like this. Like, if you are constantly choosing to not set boundaries with yourself and others, if you're constantly choosing to stay stuck in patterns of your life that you know are uncomfortable, but you know, that's just how they are. Oh, it's okay. It's not that big of a deal. If you keep telling yourself these things, if you keep choosing to be the passive person, this actually does create this ripple effect where you are not only setting the example for other people that probably look up to you, but you are also showing yourself and the universe that your wants, needs, and desires are not that big of a deal. It's not that big of a deal. Therefore, your manifestations are also not that big of a deal. So if you feel like you're being stuck or staying stuck within your manifestations, maybe it's time to ask yourself, where are you not taking yourself seriously enough? Where are you letting these small things slide? And the more that you allow these small things to slide, going back to the ripple effect, over a long period of time, all of these small things that you're letting slide are going to compound on top of one another to have this huge block in your life. And over time, as you don't choose yourself, as you don't have those boundaries, as you're not staying committed and truthful within loving yourself to the best of your ability, if you're letting these small little things slide in your life, then this is going to instill on a subconscious level that choosing what's right and best for yourself isn't that important. Therefore, keeping you stuck, blocked, paralyzed in fear from moving forward. Or maybe you're just choosing to ignore the healing work that you know you need to do. What this will do over a long period of time, with that ripple effect in mind, is essentially like a PTSD response. Yes, a PTSD response. And in a varying form here, where when over and over and over again, you're telling yourself, I'm not that big of a deal. It's not that big of a deal. My goals, not that important because of the actions and the choices you're making that aren't setting strong boundaries. The more you choose to let shit slide, because you are afraid to stand up and stand strong in your truth and your boundaries and all that you desire in life, then this is going to condition you, essentially create a trigger for you that anytime anything comes up that goes against your core values, your non-negotiables, your boundaries, or whatever else, you're gonna let that shit slide. And over years, maybe even decades of doing this, how exhausting is this going to be for you overall? And then it's like you've dug yourself so deep into a hole that it's just like, how do I get out of here? So let me ask you this. Are you aware of the patterns of your life? Are you aware of the triggers that you have? Are you aware of the ways that you're intentionally or unintentionally choosing to keep yourself stuck? So I want to ask you a couple questions. Do you have fulfilling personal relationships that are also in alignment with your core values? This includes romantic, friendship, familial, and professional relationships. If you don't know your core values, I have a free core values assessment for you on my website. All you have to do to get that free download is go to kaleroberts.com, click on the Start Here tab. It's at the top of the page, right around the registration for the Inner Goddess Awakening Workshop. Grab your core values assessment. Knowing your core values is so big. When you understand your core values, you can actually make more aligned decisions based off of that in your life. A lot of us make these unessential decisions, these decisions that ultimately don't matter. These decisions that might feel good in the moment or might sound fun in the moment, but in the bigger picture, they actually are so out of alignment for what we truly find important and desire in life that these small little goals, or these small little decisions, I should say, throw us off of the course of achieving our bigger goals. Core values are very important. That's a great first place to start when connecting into who you truly are on that deeper level. So again, go to kaleroberts.com, click on the Start Here tab to download your free core values assessment. That's such a great place to start. If you have any questions on that, don't hesitate to reach out. I'm always here helping guide you forward. So another question that I want you to ask yourself is, do you notice certain patterns within your relationships that feel uncomfortable or out of alignment with what you actually desire? Again, going back to your core values, analyzing what your core values are. In the core values assessment, I ask you to see how in alignment you are with your core values, both giving and receiving. I ask you to choose like the top 10 of the core values off of that list of so many different core values there. And I want you to look at yourself. How in alignment are you with giving yourself or honoring these core values for yourself? And then how in alignment are you receiving these core values within your most personal relationships and environments that you're putting yourself into? If you feel like you are not receiving your core values from a lot of the relationships that you're surrounded by, this is a clear indicator as to why you might be feeling drained. If you're constantly choosing to be around people that are actually going against what is most important to you within your core value structure, then this is going to make you feel like this weird pull of energy in your life. If you don't know what your core values are and you're like, oh, this person's fun to be around, or oh, this person's nice, or oh, we always have, you know, do this fun activity together, that's great. But if you're spending lots of time with people that just don't align with your core values, honey, it's a waste of time. And it's time to surround yourself with people that also hold the same values and things that are important to you to them. Now, with this being said, I don't necessarily condone living in like your own echo chamber where you're only surrounded by people that think the same way you think and act the same way you act. I am all for and totally encourage having powerful conversations with people who live different lives than you, whether it's different religious affiliations, political affiliations, or whatever else it might be. I encourage this from a place of openness and respect, because what these types of conversations can get you to do is think differently, to feel more compassion, to understand other people on a deeper level. I think this is very important for us, especially in our social economic climate as of right now. This is very important for us as a whole to be having these powerful conversations with people outside of our echo chamber, because I mean, love is what rules the world. And if we can respect and understand people that we don't necessarily believe everything that they believe, as long as they're good people, right? And they live by some value system and they try to do their best in this world and treat others with kindness and respect, then they deserve our time and attention to hear them, regardless of whether we agree with them or not. I know I'm digressing a little bit, but I do feel like this is very important to touch on. You know, around politics over this last year, I felt like there was such a divide of our nation. It's either red or blue, and it's just like, if you believe this, you're wrong. And if you believe that, you're a terrible person. If you vote for this person, I can never be your friend again. And in one sense, I understand that. But in another sense, it's like so much hate we're spewing at someone else. Like if we just took the time to hear and listen to other people instead of immediately judge and hate them based off of their political views, I feel like we could really come together as a world and make so much change happen. But so many people are just so stuck within their own echo chamber and feeling that they are right and their belief systems are right and their viewpoint and their religion and their politics and their this and their that is the only way that they shut everyone else out. And this is, it's just not creating the world that we need. We need a world of love and compassion and understanding. So getting back on track, asking yourself this question about, are you noticing certain patterns within your relationships? Do certain relationships feel out of alignment or uncomfortable? Are they aligning with your core values? If certain relationships feel out of alignment or uncomfortable, then it's time to create a boundary there. It's time to speak your truth with love, with compassion, from a place of being grounded, but also from a place of knowing your truth, knowing what your non-negotiables are, knowing what you stand for, knowing what you won't tolerate, and creating a strong boundary within all of that. So knowing your core values is great, a great first place to start. Then I want to ask you this. Do you feel like you are treading water in regards to progress with your goals, dreams, and desires? Do you feel like you've had the same goals for months or years and you just haven't made any progress? Now, of course, there's so many things that feed into all of this. Your motivation, your consistency, your mindset, your resources, your time. Lots of things feed into this. But do you feel like you're treading water in regards to progress with your goals, dreams, and desires? Do you set goals but have a hard time actually reaching them? Do you suffer from anxiety, depression, or panic attacks? And are these happening on a regular basis? Do you feel like you actually know what you want out of life? Or are you just doing things because you see other people doing them and you feel like that's what you should be doing too? When you think about your future, do you get excited about all of the possibilities, or do you feel empty because it doesn't seem like you're going to actually live that life that you dream of, that it's just stuck there in your dreams? So with all of these questions in mind, how are you feeling? Do you feel like you're taking proactive measures to do what you must in order to create this life that you've been dreaming about? Or are you kind of still half-stepping, half-approaching your progress to these goals? Have you been proactive about your healing? Or do you feel you're stuck in that too? If so, like how long have you been stuck there? Are you starting to notice a pattern where maybe you try and then you give up and then you try again and then you give up and that's obviously becoming exhausting? But what are you doing to break this cycle? Are you still trying to do it on your own? Are you actually getting the support that you know you need? Are you doing more than just the bare minimum to get the most out of your life? All of these questions, I know some of these questions are tough questions, but they are powerful questions because they're meaningful questions. And if you're truthful with yourself and the answers, and this can really uncover a lot, that's the first step, is having self-awareness. Once you're self-aware of what you're doing to positively promote yourself, what you're doing to keep yourself stuck, then you can actually take action that's aligned to help you get to where you want to be. So my love, I am excited because that is really what the essence of Inner Goddess Awakening is about. I really want to help you connect inward from this place of non-judgment, just being truthful and honest with yourself, being more self-aware about where you're at, why you're stuck where you're stuck, and how to get out of there. I know because I've done this work myself. I felt so stuck for such a long time, and I've really taken this healing journey extremely serious over the last 8 months or so. And so much has been revealed to me and about me and helped me to essentially remove the veil that was really clouding my vision and my judgment for such a long time, that was keeping me stuck within my ego and keeping me stuck perpetuating these cycles that were not serving my highest and best good. So in day one of Inner Goddess Awakening, here we are going to really take a deeper look at who you are at your core, which includes your past experiences, your upbringing, possible traumas and triggers, fears, challenges that you're having, limiting beliefs, and essentially just how you're showing up in your life, how you're thinking, how you're speaking, how you're acting and reacting. And I will guide you in understanding yourself on a deeper level than ever before. And then day two, we're going to let go and heal. Once I've shown you what is really beneath the surface, this will make it more apparent as to what is holding you back in life. And I will guide you in releasing the past, detaching from those things that are holding you back and those things that continue to hurt you. And I'm going to guide you towards your truth, your most aligned and most authentic self. And then in day three, we're going to awaken your inner goddess, and I'm going to align you with your higher self and your truth. Awaken all of this truth that lies within you. This will all make manifesting much easier and establishing quality relationships more fulfilling. And this is also just going to help awaken this new passion, this love for your life and yourself. And this is where all of your dreams and desires and goals are going to start to just click effortlessly into all of the hard effort that you've been putting into your life. So I do want to invite you in joining me in this free 3-day live training series. This is happening privately in my private Zoom room, so you do have to be registered in order to have that invite link. But if you want to register, go to kaleroberts.com, click on the Start Here tab, and you'll find the registration right there at the top of the page, right next to the free download for my core values assessment. After the 3 days, After each night of the training, I'm going to send you a replay so you can go back and rewatch it. Of course, you can reach out with any questions. I'm always here to support and guide you. But I really want you to participate in this fully, truthfully, honestly, and make this commitment to yourself. I know that you want more out of life. I know that you're listening to this episode right now because you desire more. You deserve more. But sometimes we just can't see, and sometimes we just don't know why and how we're keeping ourselves stuck. And it's really time to start breaking those patterns and stepping into the power that you hold in you right now. Just certain things need to be broken away, rewired, realigned, reconnected, and then you can really rise up with all of these new learnings that you have about yourself, all of these new appreciations that you have for yourself. So again, to sign up for Inner Goddess Awakening, go over to kaleroberts.com, click on the Start Here tab, get all registered for that. Also make sure you download that free core values assessment. And I cannot wait to see you next Monday, February 15th for day one of Inner Goddess Awakening. Thank you so much for being here with me in today's episode, and I will catch you next week. Thank you so much for joining me in today's episode. I hope you found extreme value in today's content. Of course, if you love today's episode, take a screenshot, share it on social media, and tag me in it, because not only do I love to feel all the love, but I also love to hear your feedback. Of course, if you want to get connected with me further, you can find me on my website at kaleroberts.com or on social media. I'm at The Kale Collective. Until next week, boss bitches, rise up.